Good morning, viewers. It's a new day. Welcome to today's devotion with the Daily Fountain, the devotional guide of the Church of Nigeria Anglican Communion. Invite your family and friends. Get your Bible and your Daily Fountain manual while our devotional leader takes us on today's devotion.
Good morning, viewers. You are welcome to yet another day. We thank God for waking us up this morning. And it's our prayer that as we go about our daily schedules, the power of the Lord will go before us in Jesus' name. But while we go, let us listen to the word of God through our daily devotional book. Let us pray. Almighty Father, we give you thanks, we give you praise for your grace upon our lives. Thank you, Lord, for the gift of life. Thank you, Lord, for today, the second Friday in the month of January, the year 2021. We pray, Lord, that this morning you will speak your mind to us. Give us grace to understand you better. That your word will be a light to our path day by day. For in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Viewers, today is Friday, January 8, 2021. And the topic before us this morning is obedience brings favor. Obedience brings favor. And our leading text is taken from Luke chapter 2. From verse 51, Luke chapter 2, verse 51 and verse 52. And I read, "Then Jesus went down with them and came to Nazareth and was subject to them. But his mother kept all these things in her heart. And Jesus increased in wisdom and stature and in favor with God and men." I pray and prophesy to my listener this morning that as you go about your schedules, especially in the year 2021, you will grow in God's favor, you will grow in God's wisdom, you will grow in God's knowledge, and you shall increase in God's favor and man in Jesus' name. I pray that throughout this year, the power of the Lord will guide you and you will walk in the path of righteousness. People of God, obedience brings favor. That's our theme for today. From our text, we discover where Jesus Christ obeyed the Spirit, obeyed God, and he did what God had assigned him to do. And as a result of that, we are told in the last verse where we read that because of this, Jesus Christ increased in God's wisdom. Not only that, he increased in stature, and not only that, he found favor with God and with man. That shall be your portion in Jesus' name. But in our reading yesterday, we remember Jesus' response to his parents when they met him at the temple. If you flash back to verse 49 of Luke chapter 2, verse 49 says, "And Jesus said to them," to the parents precisely, "Why did you seek me? Did you not know that I must be about my father's business?" But they did not understand the statement which he spoke to them. Jesus Christ, what was going through his mind and what he has determined to do is to be obedient to his father, come what may. And the father has saddled that responsibility upon him to always go about the business of the kingdom, to teach the people at the temple, to be there, and of course to show the light to people around him. And that was what Jesus Christ kept on doing. And was narrating this story to his parents, to his earthly parents, that one thing that I must do in life is to be obedient to my heavenly father. I can afford to do this, to do that, but I cannot afford to fail my heavenly father. Several times, people of God, we discover that many of us, we are disobedient to the injunction of our Lord Jesus Christ. And disobedience always brings cause to man. But when a man obeys God in full, favor is the result. You will be favored before men and before God. And that's exactly what Jesus Christ did in this particular place. And going through to verse 51, verse 51 of our today says that Jesus went down with his parents to Nazareth and was subject to them. He knew full well that as a human being, he's also duty bound to be obedient to his earthly parents. He did not shun them. He did not tell them that, don't you know that I'm God? Don't you know that I'm more than you? He did not only obey his heavenly parents, he also obeyed and subjected himself to his earthly parents. He followed them to Nazareth, and he did exactly what he was told to do. Though Jesus knew he came from God and had a relationship with God, yet he went with his parents to Nazareth and was obedient to them. Today we see so many things that are happening in Christendom. Some Christian leaders regard themselves so highly that they no longer respect their elder siblings. They no longer see their family members as Christian, as people that worthy to be respected. They are so arrogant, they see themselves because probably they are Christians or because they have occupied certain position in Christendom. They are leaders in the Christian community. So they no longer have regard for their parents. They don't have regard for their elder siblings. They see them as not belonging to God. But Jesus did not follow that path. Jesus, he saw himself as somebody who needed to subject himself to the tutelage of his parents. And he respected them, he followed them, he obeyed them. And of course, you know what happened afterwards. He found favor with God and also with men. It's my prayer that the Lord will favor you. As you obey God, as you do the will of God on a daily basis, especially as we begin this year 2021, I pray that the favor of the Lord will not elude you in Jesus' name. I want us to know this morning that your relationship with God should make you treat your spouse and other family members with respect and honor as befitting a child of God. Your relationship with God should not make you to puff off. Your relationship with God should not make you to be arrogant. Your relationship with God should not make you to become something else. Even though you speak in tongues, your parents don't. You are a child of God. People know that you are very talented. You can preach the Bible eloquently. But how do you see your parents? Do you still see them? Do you still subject to them? Do you still respect them? Your other siblings around you, the other colleagues around you, how do you see them? Do you still see them as being created by God? Or you are puffed up? You are so arrogant. Jesus Christ humbled himself. Jesus Christ stooped so low. He followed his parents and he was subject to them. And as a result of this, we are told that he grew up in stature. He grew up in wisdom. He obeyed God. He obeyed his parents. And because of that, God favored him and men also favored him. I pray as you humble yourself, the Lord will favor you. You will find favor before God. And you also find favor before men in Jesus' name. Now, Jesus increased in wisdom and stature and in favor with God and men. Though Jesus is God, he took human form and came into the world. As he obeyed and served his parents, he grew in wisdom, he grew in stature and favor with God and men. As a child of God, if you respect your elders, if you honor your parents and live in obedience to the word of God, you will certainly grow in wisdom and favor with God and men. And I pray the Lord will inspire you to obey your elders, to obey your parents, so that you will grow in favor with God and with men. People of God, for a man to succeed in life, one thing is paramount in your life. You must be obedient to the word of God. Only what God tells you to do, that is what you should do. If you look at the story of the wedding that took place in Cana of Galilee, John chapter 2, verse 5 precisely says, whatever he tells you to do, do it. And the servant did not object. The servant did not do otherwise. They did exactly what Jesus Christ told the servant to do. And that was why that shame, purported shame, was averted to fame. Obedience did not only bring favor, obedience to the injunction of God, we always avert shame, we always avert ridicule, and give you fame. It does not matter how highly placed you are. It does not matter your level of academics. It does not matter the certificate you have acquired. One thing is paramount in your life. Thank God we are just beginning a new year. Determine to be obedient to the word of God this year. Determine to be obedient to God this year. Determine to subject to the instruction of God this year. If you can only do what He tells you to do, I want to announce to you that sky will be your starting point. I don't know what you are planning to do this year. I don't know what you aim to achieve in the year 2021. I don't know your schedule, your program for this year. I want to encourage you, be obedient to the word of God. If you can obey God at every junction of your life, you want to get married, you are looking for a particular sister to marry, you are trusting God for a particular man to marry, the key to that success and that breakthrough is the obedience to the word of God. Only what God tells you to do, do it. Do not follow a particular sister because she's pretty. Don't follow a man because he has money. As God revealed him to you, as God told you that that sister will be your wife, listen to the voice of God. God cannot make mistake. As a man, you do not know what lies ahead. The Bible says the Lord knows the end from the beginning. You cannot see beyond your nose, but God knows. God sees afar. Follow God's instruction this year. Follow God's word for your life this year. Are you contesting? Are you aiming at going for a particular political career? Follow the instruction of God. Do not be wise in your own understanding. The Bible says, in everything, trust in God. Lean not on your own understanding. People of God, your technical know-how will fail you. Your level of ingenuity will let you down. For you to go far in the year 2021, be obedient to the word of God. And the only way you can know the word of God is for you to familiarize yourself with the scripture. How much of the scriptures do you know? Do you even have time to study the scripture? How much of the Bible do you know? Do you know why you are still at that same level? It's because you fail to obey the voice of God. Certain times we think that you are wise, you are better than your boss, you are better than your pastor. After all, me too, I read the Bible. But have you studied the mind of God per time? Do you know what God has for you through that boss? Do you know what God may be telling you through your boss? Even though you have written him off, he is not a child of God, he doesn't know Christ. But God has decided to make him your boss in a time like this. How much of God's word have you been able to discern in his life? Learn to be obedient to instruction this year. And above all, the instruction of God. If you can do that, I want to tell you, you will not miss your steps. I pray for you in the year 2021. You will not miss your steps in the mighty name of Jesus. Therefore, loving God and His work and obedience to Him, to His word, attracts favor with God and men. Loving God, walking in obedience, following the instruction of God, all these things attract favor. And I pray God will favor you this year in the mighty name of Jesus. But before you go about your daily schedule, decide to obey God this year. Make it part of your resolution that come what may, in the year 2021, I will obey God. Whose voice are you going to obey this year? Get to sing the deserting voice of men. Obey the voice of God. Respect all people. It pays to be humble. Jesus Christ humbled himself. What have you gotten that God did not give to you? That position you are, God decided to give it to you. I want to encourage you this year. Respect all people. Obey the word of God, and you will see God's favor bestowed on you this year. I pray for you this year that the Lord will favor you. The Lord will honor you. But you need to see everybody as God's creature. Do not look down on any man. Do not disrespect anybody. Do not look down. Jesus Christ humbled himself because he had the mind of God. And as I close from this exhortation this morning, I encourage you, have the mind of God in order to respect all people. Do not bring sentiment into your relationship with God. Don't say, this person, I vouch not to greet him in life. This person wounded me last year. This person injured me last year. Have the mind of God. The mind of God will overlook every sin committed by your colleagues, by your friends. Have the mind of God and move forward. Jesus Christ humbled himself. And because of that, God gave him a name that's above every name. That at the name of Jesus, every knee bows. And I pray this year, God will create that heart. God will give you that heart. A humble spirit. A heart that will be obedient to the word of God. A heart that will respect all people. And in turn, may God favor you. May the power of the Lord rest upon you. And as you go about your daily schedules, the Lord will go ahead of you. The grace to be obedient at all times, may the Lord grant unto you. In Jesus' name. Bow down your heads and let us pray. Great Father of glory, please help us today to obey and respect everybody that we come in contact with. And let your favor manifest in our lives. And I pray for all my viewers that today henceforth, may the power of the Lord rest upon you. May God favor you. May you receive favor of God and favor of men. That in your place of work this year, the Lord will favor you. In your family this year, the Lord will favor you. As you are trusting God for your life partner, you are trusting God for your own husband, you are trusting God for your own wife, in the year 2021, the Lord will favor you. I pray the Lord will strategically position you for his favor. The mercy of the Lord will locate you, and the power of God will rest upon you. Thank you, gracious Lord, for hearing us. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen.
We thank you for fellowshipping with us today. We invite you to join us tomorrow morning, same time, same station, for another special edition of the Daily Fountain. To alert the sponsor or support this program, please contact the numbers and email all showing on your screen.